Good morning. It's Tuesday. That means I'm on my way to meet Jeff for our Tuesday training sessions. This past weekend, I was out in California climbing Mount Shasta, and we got the summit. It was amazing. So I was just catching Jeff up on my Shasta climb this weekend and telling him how then and now the thing that is most sore for me is right here from doing 100 push-ups in 5 minutes, or actually 97. I was trying to get the 105.
We'll get to 100.
We'll get to 100.
Yeah.
But that was on Thursday, and I thought that would be a good idea to try. Turns out it was not a good idea right before the mountain. And I was crazy sore the whole time. But we got the summit. I was dehydrated. I felt that, a little AMS at the top. But no, it was all good, man. And so I'm here, I'm sore, I'm fighting jet lag, and I'm ready to go.
All right, let's do this.
What are we doing today?
All right, I don't know yet.
All right, I like it, let's get creative.
I don't know what we're gonna do yet, all right? But if you stay tuned, you will see what sort of magic is about to occur. Ready? Let's go.
I just got a comment that we just did the first 30 minutes of this workout using nothing but a broomstick.
All right, good, snap down. Pop up. You getting tired? Come on.
Yeah, man.
Chest to ground, chest to ground. Lift the head a little bit. There we go.
Jeff was not easy on me today. So, we're working on this.
We're working.
Yeah.
But I appreciate that you show up and you give it 110%. And that's all I ever ask for, the highest quality work that you can give. And have a good attitude and a smile the whole time. Then, hey, man, well done.
You know, I like how you were honest at the beginning, how you didn't know what we were going to do. And it was fun just like watching the gears spin inside your head every... I don't know, whenever we completed something, you'd have the next thing like that, even though you didn't know what we were doing. It was just kind of like using, I guess, how I was performing or what looked like needed work to just design what was next, rather than come in with like some pre-designed thing that might not hit all the right targets.
Totally, and this is, you know, we talked a little bit about kind of there's the science of exercise, and I do think it's really important to have kind of a long-term vision and a system in place of what, you know, what you're trying to accomplish. But I tend to be a little bit more intuitive and improvisational in my training style. So yeah, like I said, I wanted to check in with Ronzio, kind of see what his body needs today. And as we're going through the workout, we're noticing how things are moving or not moving. Keeping in mind though, the particular qualities and movements that we want to work on and strengthen. So kind of getting at those, but letting it happen and unfold in a more natural way.
So two things I want to call out is like what you were talking about my shoulder mobility, how it, like I can't get that handstand because I can't stretch above that, right?
Yeah.
And how most people, like if they're wearing a backpack or they're at the computer, like reinforce that
yeah.
Clutch shoulder, right?
Something like I wear a backpack almost every day. I call it my life pack. It travels with me wherever I go. But you know, one of the consequences of wearing a heavy backpack, especially if you're not paying good attention to your body alignment and your posture, is that it tends to reinforce that internally rotated, kind of forwardly rounded shoulders, right? Because the bag is pulling you down and back, your body wants to balance that by pulling in and forward, and it can often just lead to what we call sort of upper cross syndrome, or that same sort of hunched over body position that we find find ourselves in when we're sitting in front of a computer or something.
Which for me, I'm always on the laptop, or I'm like this weekend, you know, carrying a 60-pound pack up a mountain. Like I'm always hiking or on a laptop. And so that's the reason why my shoulder can't go more than that angle.
So little tip, experiment. If you wear a backpack, play around with flipping the pack, put it on your front, and then try to then pull your shoulder blades down and back and just realign your posture to a slightly more upright and neutral position. And it's gonna feel a little awkward. You can compensate by back bending, so try not to do that. Keep your belly in, but it's a nice little tool for you to be able to kind of become more mindful of just how your shoulders are placed, because most of us tend to have kind of a bit of a forward shoulder roll, tend to, you know, forward neck and head lean. And so those are the things that you're gonna wanna begin to work out of your system. And it happens just tiny little bits day by day, retraining yourself to just live and move in a different pattern.
All right, and in 30 seconds, what can you do with a broomstick? I loved this. It's just like, you can do this in your house anytime.
So we started with a couple broomstick warm-ups. Up and overs or shoulder dislocates is a great way for bringing some mobility. I added in a bit of a lower body movement, so we're coming into a bit of a squat pattern, and then from there, working ourselves through the overhead back down to the front. And then I had us going through a flow where we drop down onto the knees, taking a deep side bend, and then rocking back into a squat and back up. Or you can even do this from a squat position as well. Once I played around with that, then we went to a single balancing activity. All right, can we balance the broomstick and work our way down to the floor, onto our butts, and then back up at the same time without losing the stick, right? And then we brought it down to the ground, started working some foot drills, fast feet, jumping this way, working on cutting side to side this way, all right? Those are just a couple few places you can begin. All you need is a broomstick, a dowel rod, a Swiffer, whatever you have. Grab it from your home and start playing around with it.
There you go. Go sweep your kitchen and do a workout. Thanks, Jeff, as always.
Thank you.
Follow Jeff, jeffsiegelwellness.com, and just search Jeff Siegel or Jeff Siegel Wellness on Facebook. Appreciate it, man.
But yeah.